Does anyone else here live with a domestic detective? We have kids. I go out. I have to buy, you know, milk and stuff. My wife sent me out to get milk, so I'll come back with milk. Okay, got the milk. There it is. I walk in the thing. My wife will be like, "Did you use the coupon that I gave you for $1 off that milk? Did you use that?" And I'll be like, "Yeah." "Yeah, I used it." She's like, "No, you didn't, because it's right here. It's right here in the coupon basket. This is where I left it for you. Think about back and see. Now you're a liar." Or she'll come into the kitchen, and and she'll be like, "Did you just give our daughter tap water?" And I'm like, "No, no." She's like, "Yeah, you did. Yeah, you did. I can smell chlorine on her breath." Don't do that. I don't know if you guys know this. White babies are allergic to tap water. Yeah, you can't get that. She just made lieutenant, by the way. It was a big deal. We had a party. She'll walk past the bathroom upstairs, and she'll come and find me where I'm in the basement hiding. That's what I do. I like to hide in the basement. She'll come and find me. She'll come right up. She'll be like, "What did you eat? What did you eat?" You know, like, does anybody else get in trouble for pooping? Like, anybody else get busted for pooping? You know, and I don't mean like in the dryer or under the bed. I mean like in the bathroom with the spray and the flush and the fan and the brush and everything. Everything I can do to cover it up and just hide my stink. Demanding to know what I ate. What is that? Part of the reason I think we don't have that much sex anymore is that we have very different night rituals, okay? So night ritual is, you know, what you do before you go to bed, right? I mean, for instance, my night ritual is very simple, all right? It's 45 seconds for me to wake up off the couch, brush all the corn chips off my body, put my cigarette out, walk upstairs, take all my clothes off, and get in bed. That's it, okay? That's my night. It's me getting in bed. There's an optional toothbrushing in there. Maybe I will brush my teeth. Frankly, I probably will not brush my teeth. My wife's is extremely different. My wife's is about 30 minutes. It's extremely complex, multi-part, chronological. Okay, there's a very strict order to the way this is done. Starting with a full wardrobe change. I'm talking about a complete removal of all clothing down to the nudity, redressing of the self. Have to put on fresh, brand new, clean clothes, go to bed. And then there's a moisturization lubrication ritual, which is also extremely complex, multi-part, chronological. Jergens pump lotion, gotta start with that. Double pump. Jergens pump lotion can be applied to most of the body, okay? You just start down here, you get down the legs, knees, arms, the thighs, the boobs, the belly, the body, the elbows, the skin, scaly skin, dry and itchy. You can do that. You can do almost like 90% of the body until you get to the neck, okay? Once you get to the neck, you cannot put Jergens pump lotion above or on a woman's neck, okay? You know why? I don't know why, but you can't do that shit. Nobody does that. Because once you get to the neck, you gotta change cream. It's gotta be smaller and more expensive. It's probably French. It has an apostrophe in the title. Because the higher up the body you go, you're always approaching the eye. The eye, the tremendous, expensive eye, the orb of all life. This must be surrounded by the most expensive cream in the arsenal. To literally, my wife is getting to the point where she has this tiny sterling silver jar, you know, this little delicate jar. You unscrew the magical jar and it contains a cream made by Polish skin fairies, okay? It's like this, the rarest of beeswax, okay? And you can't, what you don't do is just reach your stupid finger in there and just smear it all over your eyes. You don't even touch it or your skin with it. My wife, she opens it up, she says a little prayer, and then you take out the special, he pulls out a ladybug's wing. A single ladybug's wing that she has, and just like literally takes it and just like scrapes up the finest, a bit of dust, a little, she just gasses out a little bit of this stuff and then just drift your face into it. And it settles delicately on the eye.